don't you tell the truth. You never took what I said serious. You wanted fantasy instead of faith.
Yeah.
But I want you to make a choice. I want you to choose life. Go back and examine how you've been living and make another choice that will cause your past to pale in comparison to your future. Go back and dust off my word and get back into the promises that I've made you. For every promise of God in Christ is yea.
And amen.
You know the scripture, but you haven't received it. You believe it, but you haven't received it. I challenge everyone in this room to take this seriously and personally. Lay your hand on your own chest and say, live.
Live.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. In the book of Proverbs, I believe it's 18 and 21. It says, life and death
lies in it.
Are where? But it doesn't end there. It says, life and death are in the power of the tongue. And they that love it, love what? Love life or death. You will eat the fruit of either life or death. See, we don't finish the scripture. And they that love it will rehearse it. And they that love it will repeat it. And they that love it will live it. And they that love it will live by it or die by it.
Yeah. Amen.
Your tongue kills you.
Yeah.
Because it comes out of your heart, your mouth speaks. And when you speak negatively,
yeah.
That's why I stopped saying I have diabetes. I say they diagnosed me, but I don't claim it as mine. I don't hear anybody here. I gotta change my vernacular. I gotta change my verbiage. I gotta change my words. I cannot claim what God has died to kill.
Yeah.
Yeah. I make God look bad when I claim what he died to destroy.
Yeah.
Yea, that lover will eat the fruit thereof. Why is it that we as Christians speak so negatively?
Jesus.
Why? Why is it we as Christians want the negative? We like the negative. We want to hear who fell. We want to hear who messed up. We want to hear what videos are. We want to hear who has a sex tape. We want to hear who the false prophet is. We want to see the dirt. We want the tea. We want to see the underbelly.
Jesus.
We stay online just to find out who did what.
Jesus.
And we live in the negative while we claim the positive.
Woo. Jesus.
You can claim fruit and flowers all day long, but if you live amongst weeds,
hey God,
it will kill that which is life. Am I making sense?
Yeah.
We sit back and we look at blogs and we wonder what the bloggers saying and who did what this time and what news do they have. The Bible says do your own business.
Yeah.
How are you going to mind somebody else's business?
Do your own business.
When you've got so much to tend to on your own. I don't believe they did that. Did you see that video? Did you see what they was doing? Did you see who it was? Ah! You're going to live by that.
Yes.
You that live by that, you will eat the fruit of it.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You will eat the fruit of it. It will impact your life. It will infect your life. It will disease your life. It will take away your joy. It will condemn you to live in that type of situation, and God will allow you to become hardened in that till that becomes your norm.
Yeah.
You'll find yourself addicted to it, going back and forth to it. Right now, You can't even listen to the word. Some of you are still on your phone texting other people because you are in another world. While the word of truth is going forth, you are in another world. You're not even in this service right now.
Jesus!
You can see, that's one good thing about standing in the pulpit. You can see what people are doing. You're not even in this service right now. While the word of God is going forth that can change your life, you are in somebody else's house. You are in somebody else's home. You are so detached Jesus. From God that God says, stay like that.
Jesus!
God says, stay like that. You don't believe me? Read Romans, the first chapter.
Yeah.
He said, because they refuse to retain God in their knowledge, God turned them over. Life and death are in the power of the tongue. And they that love the fruit of it, they that love it will eat the fruit. Why do you think our life is so jacked up? Why do you think we've got so much drama going on in our life? It's because of what we've set in motion. If you plant a seed, look for the harvest.
Yeah.
If you speak negative, look for the harvest.
Yeah.
If you speak sickness, look for the harvest. If you speak gossip, look for the harvest.
Yes, sir.
It will come back to you. And there's no question as to why Christians are living such hobbled lives. The word doesn't change, and the word is true. But we interfere with the word coming about in our lives because we haven't disciplined ourselves to live according to the Bible.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Amen. They can talk about me on whatever blog they want to talk about me on. Because the bottom line is, I live above that.
Yeah.
Somebody look at your neighbor and say, live.
Yeah.
Tell them, live above it.
Live above it.
Yeah, live above it. I live above that. I live above sickness. I live above poverty. I live above lust. I live above brokenness. I live above fear. I live above insecurity. I live above depression. Look at your neighbor one more time. Say, live above it. Look at your neighbor one more time and say, live above it. Because that's the life that the people shall have. That's the life that God has ordained. God finds joy when you rise.
Amen. Amen.
God is not happy when you're in your struggle. He's happy when he sees your faith in your struggle.
Yeah.
Because your faith is going to get you out of your struggle.
Amen.
Faith is not supposed to keep you satisfied in your struggle. Faith is supposed to lead you through your struggle. I don't hear anybody. Because you're not in a struggle to stay. You're not supposed to make your residence there. You're supposed to go through the valley and the shadow of death.